Hi, I'm Tori, and I am a doctor of physical therapy who specializes in pelvic dysfunction, and I think that pelvic health and pelvic issues should both be more openly discussed and widely understood because everyone has a pelvis. So today we are going to discuss why you should not hover above the toilet when you pee. In order to understand why you shouldn't hover, it's important to understand the relationship between your bladder and your pelvic floor during urination. So let's take a quick look at the bladder and pelvic floor in order to review this relationship. Imagine that this is my bladder and my pelvic floor, and I am facing you and I have been cut down the center. You can appreciate that my bladder is here, sitting on top of my urethra, and that my pelvic floor is here, living underneath my bladder and surrounding part of my urethra. Some of your pelvic floor muscles actually act as a urethral sphincter and are in charge of opening and closing the urethra depending on what you're up to. As counterintuitive as it may be, when you urinate, the smooth muscle in your bladder is actually contracting in order to push the urine inside of it out of the urethra, while simultaneously your pelvic floor is relaxing so that that urethral sphincter is open and the urine can easily and effortlessly exit the bladder through the urethra and out into the world. So when it comes to toilet positioning during urination, the ideal position would allow for pelvic floor relaxation, and it would allow the bladder, and only the bladder, to be in control of emptying itself. And hovering doesn't allow for either of those things. Here's why. The pelvic floor is one of your deep core stabilizers, which means it is on and stabilizing you when you are standing, and hovering demands even more stabilization than standing does. Your pelvic floor is also synergous with both your abdomen and your inner thighs, which means when one muscle is turned on, so is the other. So when you hover, your pelvic floor is activated not only because it needs to stabilize you, but also because your abdomen and inner thigh muscles are also activated. Furthermore, because your pelvic floor cannot fully relax in a hovering position, it is also likely true that your urethral sphincter isn't fully open, which means you probably have to strain in order to empty your bladder. Straining, where you inhale, hold your breath, and push down, essentially uses pressure in your abdomen to force your bladder to contract and push urine through a urethral sphincter that might not be totally open. It's a poor habit that can reinforce both bladder and pelvic related issues because it forces the bladder to empty, likely against the wishes of your pelvic floor, regardless of how full the bladder actually is. So please don't hover, especially if you have any bladder or pelvic floor related dysfunction, and if you're in a public restroom and feeling kind of gross about the toilet seat, either lay down some toilet paper or bring those disposable toilet seat covers with you so that you can sit on the toilet instead of hovering. If you want to learn how to sit properly on the toilet to pee, you can check out this video, and that's why you shouldn't hover above the toilet when you pee. Thank you so much for watching, and please do join me on the 10th and 20th of every month for future pelvic PSAs, with surprise PSAs on the 30th, where I attempt to cover an interesting pelvic health or pelvic issue related topic in 5 minutes or less. See you next time.